A man serving life for molesting and murdering a little girl dies in prison. It's been almost 50 years since Joan D'Alessandro's case made headlines. Tonight, her mother is speaking with News 12 New Jersey's Brittany Miller about what this means for her family.
It's easy to talk about Joan because she was quite a personality.
Rosemarie D'Alessandro says at 7 years old, her daughter, Joan, was a passionate little girl who loved dogs and daffodils.
She's fearless.
On April 19th, 1973, she says Joan left the house to deliver boxes of Girl Scout cookies.
She said, "Goodbye, Mommy, I'll be right back."
But minutes later, she was molested and murdered by her neighbor, Joseph McGowan. Joan's body found days later at a New York State park. McGowan, a science teacher, admitted to the crime and was sentenced to life in prison.
But she fought. She really fought.
But for years, D'Alessandro had to fight to keep her daughter's killer behind bars, with another parole hearing just a few years away.
It's torture.
Now, that battle is over. Bergen County prosecutors confirming McGowan died June 5th.
It was a certain shock on my body, but it was a good shock. Like there was some kind of, now this part is over.
For almost 30 years, this New Jersey mother worked to make sure McGowan never left prison alive, creating a set of state child safety laws, each of them carved in stone at this Hillsdale Memorial Garden. The Justice for Victims law removes the statute of limitations on suing certain criminals so they don't have money to appeal. Joan's law says anyone who molests or murders children under 14 will serve life without parole.
I'm so thankful that you didn't get it out. So this way, no other children, no other adults could lose their lives, suffer a lot, and that's what I feel so thankful for.
She says the family can now solely focus on Joan's legacy.
Joan's law did not apply to the D'Alessandro's case because it was not retroactive. A federal version of the law was signed by President Clinton in 1998. And this Saturday at 2 p.m., the community is gathering in front of the Hillsdale train station to celebrate Joan's legacy of hope, love, and prevention. They will also rally for no more parole hearings. Again, Saturday, 2 o'clock at the Hillsdale train station.